Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name's Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this box. Yes, it's another Ubiquiti product. This is the Ubiquiti Unify U7 Pro Max. It's a wireless 7 access point. Not going to be a big technical overview. This is to show you what is in the box, all right? So you're going to get your little conformity guide. You're probably never going to actually have a look at that. Then you're going to get a whole load of fixing options. So first off, you're going to get your drilling guide there. Then you are going to get a packet of screws and lugs for fitting on a hard surface. You are going to get a couple of longer bolts there to be able to fix this, one of the multi-fixing brackets, which I'll show you in a minute. You are going to get, if you've got a suspended ceiling, then these will clip onto your ceiling rail. You'll probably know about those. That allows you to just snap clip it in place. And you're going to get a set of longer bolts and nuts, which I'll show you how this fits again. If you're not going to clip it to the rail using these and you've got a false or a suspended ceiling, then you can use the other bits that we've got here to fit those together. And then you are going to get a little hex tool, Allen key here, and you're going to get your quick release tool, which allows you to disconnect this from the whole setup. You are then going to get two other brackets to hold it. So we'll have a look at the device in a moment, but you are going to get, first off here, this is your multi-fixing metal bracket. All right, plenty of screw hole options in there that you can see. So the idea is we can mount this to our hard surface or our wall if we want to. Remember, our Wi-Fi comes out a bit like a dome from this. There is a bit of bleed from the back. So if you put this on a wall, remember, things that are right up by that on that wall are going to get the worst bit of signal. That's why ceiling mount is probably one of the better places for these. So that's going to be mounted up in place. You can see here the cutout for your cable and for your connection points that you get on the bottom of the unit here. And then basically this is pushed up into place, twisted round and locked, and that clips up into place. If you want to then let that down, you'll see there's a little hole here, and we can use our quick release tool here to be able to push into that to release the little lever that we've got here that you can just see on the end there. Hopefully you can just see that just here. All right, and that will disconnect from the little clip nod that we have here, and that will allow you to undo it. Then if we've got a suspended ceiling that I was talking about, so what we can do is we can use this bracket, and we get a second bracket here. This goes above your ceiling. So this is going to go above your ceiling tile. And then you can use those longer bolts here that I've got to be able to bolt those together. And basically you're going to sandwich that ceiling tile in the middle like that. And then of course, obviously you're going to offer this up and clip it into place. All right, so those are all the bits that you get in the box, and then you get the device itself. All right, like I said, this is the U7 Pro Max. This is the second one of the access points in this range to be released. We had the U7 Pro. The U7 Pro Max increases the performance that we have on the spatial streams. So this is a 2x2 in the 2.4 gigahertz band. It is a 4x4 in the 5 gigahertz band, and it is a 2x2 in the 6 gigahertz band. What does that essentially mean? The more spatial streams that we have, the more simultaneous devices, if you like, or the better throughput we can get overall. So now we're moving into the area of these type of access points are meant to be able to do up to 7, 8, 9 gigabits a second. Obviously, that's only going to be ever as good as the Ethernet port that's connected. So we'll talk about that in a moment. So just show you the front of the unit. There's not probably really much, hopefully that focused up there. There's not really much to see on the sides. You can see a couple of the cutouts here. This is just allow us to get access again to some of the plates and the fixing we've got in place. You'll see this little hole here allows us to, I think this should pop out, allows us to run our cable in directly this way if we want to. And then essentially what we've got on the back here is, let me turn that around so you can see that, we've got a single Ethernet port. We've got some sort of ventilation allowed in here. We've got a single Ethernet port. I'll get my finger in the right place here. All right, this is a 2.5 gigabit a second Ethernet port and a 1 gig. All right, it's a PoE device. This is PoE, so this is PoE plus powered. That means you need to be able to deliver, do check your switch. You need to be able to deliver over 15.4 watts per port, because this will consume about 22 watts when it's running. So having a multi-gig port so we can do 1 and 2.5 gigabits a second, that's going to increase our throughput that we can actually make as usable. And then just over on this side here, we've got our little reset hole as well. So a great performing access point. I'm sure that we're going to see some more in this range as well as they increase the spatial streams through them. But if you're looking at really good performance in that 5 gigahertz band and with wireless 7, then this is definitely the unit to go for. And obviously that it has a 2.5 gigabit a second Ethernet port. So you need to make sure you've got a switch if you want to get the best performance out of this. This also has a 2.5 gigabit a second switch port. But if you haven't, this will run as normal 1 gig as well. So hopefully that's been useful. Head on over to our YouTube channel. Got plenty more box openings on network, firewall, wireless devices, how-to guides on how to set up Unify Network or Unify Protect, or even, you know, some of the other things like Unify Access. So why don't you head over there, subscribe, and stay up to date.